ऑटो सजेशन द मीडियम फॉर इन्फ्लुएंसिंग द सबकॉन्शियस माइंड। ऑटो सजेशन इज अ टर्म विच अप्लाइज टू ऑल सजेशंस एंड ऑल सेल्फ एडमिनिस्टर्ड स्टिमुलाई विच रीच वंस माइंड थ्रू द फाइव सेंसेस। स्टेटेड इन अनदर वे, ऑटो सजेशन इज सेल्फ सजेशन। इट इज द एजेंसी ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन दैट पार्ट ऑफ द माइंड वेयर कॉन्शियस थॉट्स टेक्स प्लेस एंड दैट विच सर्व एज द सीट ऑफ एक्शन फॉर द सबकॉन्शियस माइंड। थ्रू द डोमिनेटिंग थॉट्स विच वन परमिट्स टू रिमेन इन द कॉन्शियस माइंड, whether these thoughts be negative or positive is immaterial. The principle of auto-suggestion voluntarily reaches the subconscious mind and influences it with these thoughts. No thought, whether it be negative or positive, can enter the subconscious mind without the aid of the principle of auto-suggestion, with the exception of thoughts picked up from the ether. Stated differently, all sense impressions which are perceived through the five senses are stopped by the conscious thinking mind and may be either passed on to the subconscious mind or may be rejected at will. The conscious faculty therefore serve as an outer guard to the approach of the subconscious. Nature has so built man that he has absolute control over the material which reaches his subconscious mind through his five senses. Although this is not meant to be construed as a statement that men always exercise this control, in the great majority of instances he does not exercise it, which explains why so many people go through life in poverty. Recall what has been said about the subconscious mind resembling a fertile garden spot in which weeds will grow in abundance if the seeds of more desirable crops are not sown therein. Auto-suggestion is the agency of control through which an individual may voluntarily feed his subconscious mind on thoughts of a creative nature, or by neglect permit thoughts of a destructive nature to find their way into this rich garden of mind. Remember, therefore, when reading aloud the statement of your desire through which you are endeavoring to develop a money consciousness, that the mere reading of the words is no consequence unless you mix emotion or feeling with your words. If you repeat a million times the famous Emil Kao formula, day by day, in every way, I am getting better and better, without mixing emotion and faith with your words, you will experience no desirable results. Your subconscious mind recognizes and acts upon only thoughts which have been well mixed with emotion or feeling. This is a fact of such importance as to warrant repetition in practically every chapter, because the lack of understanding of this is the main reason the majority of people who try to apply the principle of auto-suggestion get no desirable results. Plain, unemotional words do not influence the subconscious mind. You will get no appreciable results until you learn to reach your subconscious mind with these thoughts or spoken words which have been well emotionalized with belief. Do not become discouraged if you cannot control and direct your emotions the first time you try to do so. Remember, there is no such possibility as something for nothing. Ability to reach and influence your subconscious mind has its price, and you must pay that price. You cannot cheat even if you try to do so. The price of ability to influence your subconscious mind is everlasting persistence in applying the principles described here. You cannot develop the desired ability for a lower price. You and you alone must decide whether or not the reward for which you are striving, that is the money consciousness, is worth the price you must pay for it in effort. Wisdom and cleverness alone will not attract and retain money, except in a very few rare instances where the law of average favors the attraction of money through these sources. The method of attracting money described here does not depend upon the law of averages. Moreover, the method plays no favorites. It will work for one person as effectively as it will for another. Where failure is experienced, it is the individual, not the method, which has failed. If you try and fail, make another effort and still another until you succeed. Your ability to use the principle of auto-suggestion will depend very largely upon your capacity to concentrate upon a given desire until that desire becomes a burning obsession. When you begin to carry out the instruction in connection with the sixth step described in the second chapter, it will be necessary for you to make use of the principle of concentration. Let us here offer suggestion for the effective use of concentration. When you begin to carry out the first of the six steps, which instructs you to fix in your mind the exact amount of money you desire, hold your thoughts on that amount of money by concentration or by fixation of attention with your eyes closed until you can actually see the physical appearance of the money. Do this at least once each day. As you go through these exercises, follow the instruction given in the chapter on faith and see yourself actually in the possession of the money. Here is a most significant fact. The subconscious mind takes any order given it in a spirit of absolute faith and acts upon those orders, although the orders often have to be presented over and over again through repetition before they are interpreted by the subconscious mind. Following the preceding statement, consider the possibility of playing a perfectly legitimate trick on your subconscious mind by making it believe, because you believe it, that you must have the amount of money you are visualizing, that this money is already awaiting your claim, that the subconscious mind must hand over to you practical plans for acquiring the money which is yours. Hand over the thought suggested in the preceding paragraph to your imagination and see what your imagination can or will do to create practical plans for the accumulation of money through transmutation of your desire. Do not wait for a definite plan through which you intend to exchange services or merchandise in return for the money you are visualizing, but begin at once to see yourself in possession of the money, demanding and expecting meanwhile that your subconscious mind will hand over the plan or plans you need. Be on the alert for these plans, and when they appear, put them into action immediately. When the plans appear, they will probably flash into your mind through the sixth sense in the form of an inspiration. This inspiration may be considered a direct telegram or a message from infinite intelligence. Treat it with respect and act upon it as soon as you receive it. Failure to do this will be fatal to your success. When visualizing the money you intend to accumulate, see yourself rendering the service or delivering the merchandise you intend to give in return for this money. This is important.